Hey guys, in this video we're gonna talk about the Land of the Rising Sun. Once you step off the plane in Tokyo, you'll feel like you had stepped into some sort of nirvana that was tailor-made for you. Japan is located on the Japanese archipelago, consisting of almost 7,000 islands. The four largest of these are Honshu, Hokkaido, Kyushu, and Shikoku. The climate of Japan is predominantly temperate, but varies greatly from north to south. The island of Hokkaido gets plenty of snow during the winter. About 73% of Japan is forested, mountainous, and unsuitable for agricultural, industrial, or residential use. The nature of Japan is beautiful and diverse, from subtropical evergreen forests in the south to coniferous forests in the north. Japan has 108 active volcanoes. It's substantially prone to earthquakes, tsunami, and volcanoes due to its location along the Pacific Ring of Fire. Japan's population is estimated at around 128 million. Japanese society is linguistically, ethnically, and culturally homogeneous, composed of 98.5% ethnic Japanese. The population density is very high, 336 people per square kilometer. More than half of Japanese population live in the cities, the largest of which are Tokyo. The Greater Tokyo area is the most populous metropolitan area in the world, with upwards of 37 million people, with neon-lit skyscrapers and ancient temples side by side. Yokohama is the second largest city in Japan by population and Japan's largest port city. It's very well known for its Sankei and Garden, a botanical garden, and the seaside Minato Mirai district, site of the 926-meter landmark tower. Osaka. Osaka is a large port city and a commercial center on the Japanese island of Honshu. It's known for its modern architecture, nightlife, and hearty street food. Sapporo, the capital of the mountainous northern Japanese island of Hokkaido, is famous for its beer, skiing, hot springs, and annual Sapporo Snow Festival featuring enormous ice sculptures. Since privatization in 1987, dozens of Japanese railroad companies compete in regional and local passenger transportation markets. Japanese trains are famous for their safety and punctuality. On weekdays, most prefer to travel by public transportation or bicycles. To come to work by car can sometimes be considered rude. Their railroad communication is very well developed. The total length of the railroads is 27,000 kilometers. The symbol of modern Japan is famous ultra-high-speed trains, Shinkansen, that can reach a maximum speed of 320 kilometers per hour. Proposals for a new maglev route between Tokyo and Osaka are at an advanced stage. They drive on the left side in Japan. Japan's road spanning has been extensive. It's 1.2 million kilometers of paved road. People drive here on the left side. On the highways, the maximum speed is 100 kilometers an hour, which you will agree is very slow for sports car enthusiasts. Japan takes the second place in the world after China in the length of underground tunnels, 4,000 kilometers. In Japan, there is a separate category of cars, K-car. They have yellow license plates, and in fact, they can be identified by their appearance. They are super small and with a very distinctive design. Their drivers receive tax and insurance cuts. For every 1,000 people, there are 593 cars in Japan. It's the third largest car manufacturer in the world after China and the US, the homeland of such auto brands as Honda, Nissan, Suzuki, Mazda, and others. Sports here is very popular. First of all, Japan is associated with martial arts such as karate and sumo wrestling. Modern Japan is also interested. Also popular are baseball, football, golf, and motor racing. The Suzuka International Racing Course is one of the oldest remaining tracks of the Formula One World Championship, and such popular sport as drifting was invented in Japan in the 1960s. In terms of GDP, Japan ranks the third in the world after the US and China, despite the fact that Japan has very few energy resources. This country is very advanced in high technologies, robotics and electronics, automobile and shipbuilding. It's home to such brands of electronics as Canon, Sharp, Sony, Panasonic, and others. The country has the lowest unemployment rate in the world, 3%. On the average, the salary is $2,600 per month. The Japanese are real workaholics. Vacation is just 10 days a year at best. For many, the main goal of life is to increase the prosperity of the country and the firm they're working at. Staying late at work, coming to work on weekends, and even not taking a vacation altogether is the norm in Japan. In Japanese, they even have a special word, karoshi, which can be translated literally as overworked death. If you think Japan is all high-tech, think not. Many enterprises still use fax machines, and managers of companies of senior age do not want to change anything and just act the old-fashioned way. Housing in Japan is expensive. For example, in May 2016 in Tokyo, the average price per square meter was anywhere from $4,000 to $8,000. In cities, very tiny one-room apartments are very common, in which there is only a single room measuring about 10 square meters and a kitchen about 5 square meters. But the average area of a house in Japan is not the smallest, it's actually 95 square meters. Compare that to Britain, where it's only 76. Water in the house is expensive, so people often reuse water from the laundry. In winter, Japanese apartments can be cold because there is no central heating. Capsule hotels, the most economical kind of a hotel, which is very popular in Japan. Most typical guests are Japanese men who are not willing to go home right after work, or they're drunk, or they just want to spend some time alone. Foreign languages are not very common in Japan. After all, 98% of Japanese people are Japanese. Let's listen to what Japanese sounds like.
Domo, Hina-chan da yo. Jitsu wa kono aida, tsutsugyou shimashita. Yay!
Foreigners who live permanently in Japan have a hard time. You're always in the center of attention, and even after living 20 years in the country, you will be complimented with such lines as, "What a fine fellow! You learn how to use chopsticks! Why does Japan remain Japan?" Firstly, because of its geographical distance, and secondly, the migration policy in Japan is very tough. For example, in 2014, there were only about 5,000 applications for refugee status, of which only 16 were satisfied. But even if you do get your dream job in Japan, you can never become one of them. You'll always be an outsider, even if you look Asian, like Koreans and Chinese. In Japan, education is quite expensive. There is very high competition here, and therefore, to achieve success, you have to compete and compete a lot. Children are constantly under pressure from both parents and teachers, reminding them that they have to be the best. Customer service is very different from American. When you enter the store, you'll be welcomed, but that's about it. You will not hear, "If you like that, we have this in stock as well. Do you want me to show you that?" No, no one's gonna bother you until you're ready to buy something. Japanese service is all about respect for the client. The Japanese fashion is associated with something bright and vulgar, but these are the images that Google gives you when you search for fashion in Japan, but in reality it's not. Yes, blue hair, insane outfits, and painted eyes, but the average Japanese is not like that. Japanese women are crazy about everything European. The medical mask has long been part of the national outfit in Japan. In winter, they wear it so that they don't get infected. In the spring, because of allergies. In the summertime, because of the dust. Also, Japan amuses the whole world with its insane talk shows, which go over the limits of decency. The Japanese love to sing karaoke. In fact, this entertainment was invented here. And Japanese anime and comics are the back door into the world of Japanese consciousness. Through them, you can understand and appreciate the country a lot more. The traditional cuisine of Japan is based on rice with miso soup and other dishes. There's an emphasis on seasonal ingredients. Side dishes often consist of fish, pickled vegetables, and vegetables cooked in broth. Seafood is common, often grilled, but often served raw as sashimi or in sushi. No matter how famous the sake is, still the most popular drink in Japan is beer. The Japanese hardly ever invite their guests to their homes, preferring to hang out or do business in restaurants and cafes. Tipping in Japan is not accepted, they just don't do it. Only in Japan you can meet incredible combinations of tastes. For example, ice cream with the taste of shrimps, tomatoes or even python, Kit Kat with a taste of wasabi, Pepsi with a cucumber flavor. Japan has the highest life expectancy in the world. I'm not exaggerating. 83.7 years. The Japanese love order and rules and everything. People are constantly under social pressure. People often complain to the police about their neighbors, about garbage and vehicles parked in the wrong place. Also, the Japanese man do not give too many compliments to ladies, especially if they're not familiar with the girl. It's related to Japanese culture where they expect you to remain modest and not show off your feelings. This has been taught to them since childhood. Do not bother others. Often Japanese women will take the first steps in building a relationship. For Japanese women, security is very important. If a guy doesn't have a lot of savings or a career, it's very unlikely for a girl to marry him. Morning rush hour in Tokyo might be crazy, but nothing feels out of control like it does in New York City or Toronto. People are expected to behave a certain way in public, and they do. People are expected to behave a certain way in public, and everything is in order. Japan is a beautiful chaos, bending but never breaking. And what interesting facts do you know about Japan? Let me know in the comment section below.